went to Fir'aun, يا فرعون, we will have no more servants to serve us. So he deemed or decreed, okay, 1 year we will spare the lives, and 1 year they shall be killed. That year where they spared their lives was born Harun. And that year where they were to be killed was born Musa. Are you following? Was born Musa. Now they're looking for any newly born. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired the mother of Musa. She wants to protect her baby. فَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ أَنْ أَرْضِعِيهِ. Allah knows. And the sister should be listening to this. Because the sisters, they know. Any woman who's pregnant and she is about to deliver the baby and she delivers the baby, the very first wish she wants is to breastfeed her baby. All the women understand this. And Allah knows the wish and the intent of the mother of Musa. So he inspired her. فَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ أَنْ أَرْضِعِيهِ. And we inspired the mother of Musa, breastfeed your baby, suckle him. فَإِنْ خِفْتِ عَلَيْهِ فَأَلْقِيهِ فِي الْيَمِّ وَلَا تَخَافِي وَلَا تَحْزَنِي. Two commands. وَلَا تَخَافِي وَلَا تَحْزَنِي إِنَّا رَادُّهُ إِلَيْكِ وَجَعِلُهُ مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired her, suckle your baby. So subhanallah, brothers, subhanallah, we men, maybe we don't understand this. You know that when women give birth, they go to labor, all the pain they go through, all the hardship, all the screaming, as soon as she puts or you put the baby on her chest, she forgets about the pain. Allah. And the baby starts suckling. She forgets about all the pain. All she wants is to suckle her baby. So she suckled her baby and he told her, throw him into the river. Cast him into the river. Ya Rabbi, I want to save him. Yes, if you want to save him, cast him into the river. Why? We shall bring him back to you. Allah gave her two commands. And two commands versus two promises. The command is, suckle him. Second command, cast him. Throw him into the river. The promise, we shall bring him back to you and we shall make him a messenger. So she fulfilled the vision. She cast him into the river. I want to save my baby. And lo and behold, subhanallah, the current takes the basket where Musa was into the river. Current takes him where? Takes him into the palace of Fir'aun. She wants to save him from Fir'aun. He goes to Fir'aun. Why? Because Allah has other plans. وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ. He has to go to the palace of Fir'aun. He has to grow up in the palace of Fir'aun. He has to learn the skills because later on he will need those skills to be able to guide and take Banu Israel out from the enslavement that they've been enslaved in Egypt through Fir'aun. So he goes. As he has picked him up, قُرَّةُ عَيْنٍ لِي وَلَكَ يَا فِرْعَوْنَ. Subhanallah, the wife of Fir'aun, she didn't have no babies. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave her Musa. As soon as she picked up Musa, she says, قُرَّةُ عَيْنٍ لِي وَلَكْ يَا فِرْعَوْنَ. He will be the coolness to our eyes. And lo and behold, Musa was quiet. As soon as they picked him up, he started crying. He's crying. What does he want? He's hungry. He wants to suck and he wants to eat, right? So they started bringing women. He refused. فَحَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَرَاضِعِ. All the women who tried to breastfeed him, Musa refused to suckle from any woman. His sister was there. فَقُصِّيهِ. We told his sister, go and follow. See where he goes. Mom, where is Musa? Musa is with Fir'aun. They picked him up. Come running. She goes running. لَوْلَا أَنْ رَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قَلْبِهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we made her chest hold strong and firm because she could have said, he's my son. They will kill her and kill him and kill the daughter. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave her that hikmah. Musa. And then Fir'aun gave her Musa. She took Musa and then she put him on her chest and Musa started suckling. He's suckling. He's eating. He's quiet. Fir'aun, all these other women, Musa did not want to eat from them except the mother, his own mother. Fir'aun told her, do you want to take this baby, suckle him, feed him, and then we'll give you an allowance, we'll pay you. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfilled the first promise. He brought him back. Musa grew up. Let me cut the story because of lack of time. Quickly. Musa grew up in the palace. And Allah has to test him. He used to go to visit his mom. So he got acquainted with Banu Israel. And then he goes back to his palace. He never said, that's my mom. He never said that. He goes back one day as he goes to his village to visit his mom and his family. He found two people fighting. هَذَا مِنْ شِعَتِهِ وَهَذَا مِنْ عَدُوِهِ He found two people fighting. One from his side, from Banu Israel, and one from his enemies, يعني the Egyptians. Musa had to make a decision. And sisters and brothers, listen up. When you start practicing Islam, once you know the truth, Allah will have to test you. It's a sunnah of Allah in this universe. Once you know the truth, Allah will have to trial you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing Musa. Musa, who are you going to side with? Musa used to be called Prince Musa. Amir Musa. Prince Musa. If he was to side with the Banu Israel, he will lose the title. He will lose the title. He will be imprisoned. They will be killed. But if he was to side with the Banu Israel, then and only then, he will receive something else. So Musa made the right choice. He sided with the oppressed. The news spread that Musa killed a man from the Egyptians, from the Coptics. So he fled. He fled Egypt. He escaped and he ran all the way to Madian, Jordan, Bilad al-Sham. He remained there for 10 years and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired Musa to come back. He has a mission. اذهبا إلى فرعون إنه طغى فقل له قولا لينا لعله يذكر أو يخشى. Go you and your brother to Fir'aun. This is your mission. He is enslaving Banu Israel. The same people, listen up. Listen up. The same people who've been enslaved by Fir'aun, they are enslaving the world today. Aren't they? They are enslaving the world today. And they are enslaving our brothers and sisters and killing them in Gaza, in Palestine. Those same people, na'am, that Allah sent Musa to, that Allah sent 120,000 prophets to, are enslaving the world, and I'm not ashamed to say it. So Allah inspired him, go to Fir'aun and confront him and let him free Banu Israel because he's enslaving them. The story is long. Shorten it. He goes. He confronts Fir'aun. Fir'aun does not want to listen. He shows this miracle, the miracle of the staff turning into serpents and whatnot. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Musa, Oh Musa, Fir'aun wants to kill Bani Israel. فَأَسْرِ بِعِبَادِي لَيْلًا إِنَّكُمْ مُتَّبَعُونَ وَتُوكِ الْبَحْرَ رَهْوَى Oh Musa, take people by Israel at night, in the midst of the night, and flee Egypt. Why? Because Fir'aun is going to kill them. So Musa called Bani Israel, 100,000 of them. It's been said by Ibn Abbas, 100,000 they fled Egypt, going towards Palestine. Going towards Palestine. And in Palestine, there were inhabitants there before Banu Israel, who they claim now that it is their land. It is the land of the Palestinians. So, and they reached the Red Sea. As they reached the Red Sea, now Banu Israel, those with the weak iman, they said, Inna lamudrakun. We are doomed. We are done. We perished. البحر من أمامنا والعدو أمامنا the ocean is in front of us and the enemy is behind us. They said إنا لمدركون. موسى said كلا إن معي ربي سيهدي. كلا nay nay إن معي ربي. Allah is with me and he shall save me. وأوحينا إلى موسى أن يضرب بعصاك البحر فانفلق. فانفلق. Oh Musa, Allah revealed to Musa, Oh Musa, strike the ocean with your staff. فانفلق. And then the ocean parted before the eyes of Musa and Harun and Bani Israel. صار كالطود العظيم. كل فرق كالطود العظيم. And then it became like two, the ocean split apart. Each side became like a huge mountain. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made 12 paths to Bani Israel to cross the ocean. 12 paths. Why 12 paths? 12 sabat of the aqwam of Bani Israel. Allah made the ground firm for them to cross. And Musa is walking and looking back. Fir'aun is coming. Fir'aun is coming. Yalla harash ya Bani Israel. Yalla quickly, quickly, jaldi, jaldi. Yalla, they're coming. He didn't say jaldi. He'll come in, he'll come in. And then they crossed the river. Musa took the staff. Musa took the staff and he started striking it back. After Bani Israel crossed, he's striking back the ocean, the ocean to come back. Allah revealed to Musa, I did not tell you to strike the ocean. Did I? I did not tell you to strike it. Cross the ocean. Yalla, roh. He left. Fir'aun came. And then he looked. And he was hesitant. Shall I cross, not cross, cross, not cross? His host crossed. His host crossed. As soon as the leader crossed, all the soldiers crossed after him. And then he goes in the midst of the ocean. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the ocean to come back. And the waves went back, and then Fir'aun got drowned. As he was getting drowned, قال Fir'aun, he says, آمَنْتُ بِالَّذِي آمَنَتْ بِهِ بَنُو إِسْرَائِيلِ. Now? Now? He didn't even say, آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ. He didn't say, I believe in Allah. He says, I believe in that whom Banu Israel believe in. وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. I am from the Muslims. Allah replied, الْآنَ وَقَدْ عَصَيْتَ مِنْ قَبْلِ. And now, you know what this reminds me of, brothers and sisters, in 1 minute or two? Reminds me of those people who may be going through hardships. Huh? They may be going through some sickness. Maybe looking for a job. And they say, Ya Rabbi, please, I will become good. I will pray. I will wear hijab. Just do me this. Just give me this. I will wear niqab. I will start praying. I will come to Fajr. Ya Rabbi, I promise, just like the promises we made in Ramadan. And then we did not fulfill them. And now, Allah is telling you, now you say, La ilaha illallah, too late. So much so that Jibreel came and he took the mud and started putting it into the mouth of Fir'aun. Why are you doing that? He says, I don't want him to say, La ilaha illallah. I don't want him to say, La ilaha illallah. Allah revealed to Jibreel, by my majesty, if he was to say, La ilaha illallah, I would have forgiven him. The same Fir'aun who said, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. If he was to say, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا, Allah would say, forgive him. Brothers and sisters, this story happened in this month. The story where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Musa. And the Prophet Muhammad used to celebrate these days by fasting. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Bismillah walhamdulillah wa salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Brothers and sisters, let us do what the Prophet Muhammad, you know, instruct us to do inshallah ta'ala, and tell our children, let us do a lot of fasting, because this is the month, as we call it, month of Allah al-Muharram. Sins are gratified and also good deeds are gratified in this particular month of Muharram. So try to do more good deeds. Try to pay, you know, give charity. Try to do Qiyam al-Layl. Try to read the Quran. Try, inshallah, not to miss any salah. And the most is try to do your fasting and tell your children to fast. Tell them to fast this month and explain to them as to why we should be fasting, inshallah ta'ala, in the month of Muharram. Today is Friday. Those of you who maybe have fasted, you know, Tuesday, which is Muharram, which is Ashura, and then Wednesday and Thursday, you could have fasted also today, because today is the first day of the white days. Ayyam al-Bayt. So you still can fast tomorrow, Saturday and Sunday, 14, 13, 14, 15 of every month. So you can fast tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala, and Sunday, as they are the white days. And then Monday, which is the day where the Prophet Muhammad used to fast always, Mondays and Thursdays. Try. Do your best. If you cannot, at least try to fast maybe, you know, few days in this month, inshallah ta'ala, and tell your children and your families to do so. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك. يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث وأغثنا. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان، اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في الشيشان وفي كشمير وفي روهينيا وفي الشام، اللهم انصرهم في الشام، اللهم انصرهم في اليمن، اللهم انصرهم في السودان، اللهم انصرهم في السودان، اللهم انصرهم في فلسطين، اللهم انصرهم في فلسطين، اللهم يا رب انصر إخواننا في غزة، اللهم ارفع يا رب بلاك عنهم، اللهم ارفع بلاك عنهم، اللهم داوي جرحاهم، اللهم آمن روعاتهم، اللهم يا رب اشف مرضاهم، اللهم ارحم موتاهم، اللهم اجبر كسرهم، اللهم قهر عدوهم، اللهم قهر عدوهم، اللهم سدد رميهم، اللهم سدد رميهم، اللهم سدد رميهم يا رب العالمين، اللهم يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث واغثنا، اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. عباد الله، ان الله يأمر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون واقم الصلاه. There are some people who are sick. Please make dua for them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give shifa to all those who are sick, insha'Allah ta'ala. I was looking for my phone. استوى القدس يرحمكم الله لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده ربنا لك الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر اللهم لا إله إلا أنت اللهم إني السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله
So when you go, when you are going out, please don't forget that
how are you doing? Okay. What time no see?
Yeah.
Did your daughter get married? Did your daughter get married?
No.
That guy approached me.
I know.
Okay. I don't know.
No,
it's okay. No, leave it up to you.
Yeah.
Isn't he a Muslim?
I got medication. You know, she's seeing a psychiatrist. It's been 2 years already. So she didn't inform us. And second part, the main thing is,